Hey, welcome to EPN. My name is Victor Lucas, and we bring you the latest in everything cool every single day. Today's rundown is going out to Dan Wood, who enjoyed my Forza Horizon 4 review yesterday. Says, gotta love the Playground crew. Hashtag electric playground. Hashtag playground games. That's very cool. This rundown is all yours. Facebook and Oculus have begun their annual Oculus Connect conference, and they've made some big announcements. First up, they announced an all-new next-generation headset called the Oculus Quest. It's an all-in-one, self-contained unit that packs the necessary hardware into the headset itself, so you don't need to be connected to a computer. This isn't their first self-contained headset. They released the Oculus Go earlier this year, but that device could only run simpler mobile-quality games, while the new Oculus Quest is more comparable to the quality of the flagship Oculus Rift. It's still taking a little hit in terms of quality, but Oculus is hoping that by squeezing all the hardware into the headset, they'll make VR more accessible and help open it up to the mainstream buyers. The Oculus Quest lands in spring 2019 and will cost $400 US. Now, this is a huge move, and Oculus has been sort of suggesting that they were working towards this for many years. It's finally upon us, and I think this is going to be a bit of an upstart, a bit of a shakeup in the VR community. We've been wanting untethered VR and sort of, you know, much better quality experiences for a long time. It's finally happening. This is good news. Is it enough good news that it's going to change perception and really start to make massive sales and a big dent into the marketplace out there? It's a little too soon to call. But if this one doesn't, I think VR has got some really big hurdles to surmount, for sure. But that's very exciting news, and congrats to everybody at Oculus. And if you're looking for something to play in VR, there were loads of big game announcements at Oculus Connect. Ready at Dawn announced Lone Echo 2, a sequel to last year's Oculus-exclusive outer space game. The story will be a direct continuation from the first game, with players once again taking the role of a robot named Jack aboard an orbital mining station. It hits Oculus devices next year. If you need more robots, Spider-Man developer Insomniac Games has announced that their next big project, the VR game Stormland, will launch in 2019. First unveiled at E3 earlier this year, Stormland is a first-person game where you take the role of a cute robot struggling for survival on an alien world, and it will combine shooting with platforming. This is actually Insomniac's fourth VR game, and after Spider-Man, they've set a very high bar for themselves. If you still need more robots, a new mech game called Vox Machina got a surprise launch yesterday on the Oculus Rift, as well as the HTC Vive and Windows MR devices. It's an online game where teams of giant mechs will battle each other, and it basically looks like a VR version of Titanfall. Finally, nothing is more mainstream than Star Wars. Oculus and ILM XLab are joining forces to create Vader Immortal, an episodic VR game where players will wield a lightsaber and encounter Darth Vader. The story takes place between the prequels and the original trilogy and is being written by the Dark Knight co-writer David S. Goyer, who also wrote another Star Wars VR experience, Secrets of the Empire. The first of three episodes will launch in spring 2019. You know, it's going to be that Star Wars that gets people to put on the headsets. I'm excited to play these games. Congrats to Ready at Dawn for getting the increased investment into the studio. They've developed some incredible stuff around Lone Echo already, so I'm psyched for more. This makes me very excited to put on a VR headset and jump back into the VR space. I've got VR games lined up to review, so stay tuned for some of that. I'll be streaming some as well. But this is great news, man. I mean, Facebook and Oculus are not giving up, and they're not sort of stepping off of the gas. They are definitely going out there and collecting some cool partnerships, especially important for gamers like us. I think that VR has many other applications, and AR has a lot of applications outside of games, but I think it's games that bring people in, and it's just conducive to some really quality, fun experiences out there. So this is all exciting news if you're a fan. I want to know from you, though, is it exciting enough to get you in? Are you now looking at your budget and, this spring 2019 launch of Oculus Quest and saying, well, I've got to get into the VR? Or are you sort of pacing around trying to figure out if PlayStation VR is going to be your thing? Are you excited about VR and the games and the technologies that are headed to us in that space enough that you're going to spend some money and get involved? Let me know in the comments below. All right, the PC Gaming Master Race won't have a monopoly on mouse and keyboards for much longer. Xbox head Phil Spencer has announced that mouse and keyboard support is coming to the Xbox One. The first game to have it will be the online shooter Warframe, and it will be available next month through the Xbox Insider program, with a wide release following soon after. Don't expect every Xbox game to support mouse and keyboard, though. Microsoft says that they're opening up support for developers who want it, so it'll be up to game makers to decide if and when their games get support. Phil Spencer points out that developers will also be able to tweak their online matchmaking so that players with one kind of control input won't be able to go up against players with another. And yes, the mouse and keyboard experts are going to completely demolish all of you first-person players out there. I have definitely gravitated to a gamepad, and I love the DualShock 4, and I love the Xbox One controller, and I'm a big fan of the Switch Pro controller. I'm just more comfortable in that space now. And when I do go back to mouse and keyboard at events and things like that, and I have a gaming PC set up in my gaming cave, and when I use the mouse and keyboard, I can still get around and be fairly competent, but I certainly don't have the skills that I used to have when I was younger and, you know, hot on playing all these shooters on the PC. It's amazing how times have changed, but that's a good move on Xbox's part. We'll see how much adoption that gets and whether that means that, Sony will eventually offer it for PlayStation gamers as well. All right, we'll take a look at what might be one of the last X-Men movies, at least in the current series. Fox has released the first trailer for Dark Phoenix, the latest entry in their long-running Marvel Mutant movie franchise. The film is based on the popular Dark Phoenix Saga comic series from the early 80s and will focus on the powerful mutant Jean Grey, with Game of Thrones actress Sophie Turner reprising a role from 2016's X-Men Apocalypse. Dark Phoenix marks the directorial debut of longtime X-Men producer Simon Kinberg, and we have to point out that this could be one of the last X-Men movies released before Marvel Studios takes control of the franchise. Fox, as we all know, is in the process of being acquired by Marvel's parent company, Disney, and they plan to eventually add the X-Men characters to the shared Marvel Cinematic Universe. Simon Kinberg is already a Disney veteran, having worked on several new Star Wars films, but it remains unclear how the characters will be brought in or if the roles will be recast. Dark Phoenix was originally slated to land in November, but was delayed to February 14th, 2019, so happy Valentine's Day, X-Men fans. I'm excited to see this movie because it does feel like we're visiting old friends and old sets, and we're going back to the familiar. I do have to say, though, that I'm excited about the idea of a complete reinvention for the X-Men and sort of thinking of them in new terms. You know, we were all hesitant about a new Spider-Man movie, and then Spider-Man Homecoming starring Tom Holland came out, and we've got this exceptional actor in this exceptional role, and it's a perfect fit, and it is a reinvention with that character. I'm not, suggesting that the Bryan Singer-started X-Men franchise was bad. There have been incredible movies in that franchise. I still think X2 is one of my favorite superhero movies of all time. The original X-Men was great. I loved First Class. But I don't know. I feel like I've seen this world a lot. We've seen a lot of these situations before. Maybe this is a great way to kind of send them all off, and then Marvel gets to kind of reboot everything again. February 14th is right around my birthday, so maybe this will be a fantastic birthday present. All right, guys, that's going to do it for our rundown today. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget, we make new content all the time, so make sure you check out some of the other stuff that we've been making. And if you do like our stuff, don't forget to hit subscribe, that little bell, and you can also press that join button to become an EPN member. Thanks for watching, and play forever.